Welcome to the BF Anderson Technical Report for December the 8th. You know, going through history is a great exercise in building confidence and what you're trying to accomplish. Now, I have a graph here of the NASDAQ going back to 1980. Now, I think it's important to know your market history and to also know that there is always going to be change. And so today I'm going to talk a little bit about changes that we're seeing that we think are important. The market, starting the week after Thanksgiving, started to make some major changes. We think some new leadership is evolving, and let's talk about it. The main thing to remember is that all bull markets that I have experienced and have studied are led by new things. They're led by new technologies. I mean, if you go back to the 50s, 60s, 70s, you're going to find that there were new technologies that created business opportunities that really made certain stocks work well. The other thing is that once you go through these corrections, like here we had a correction. This was the 1987 market crash, the infamous crash. But as you can see, the consolidation in the NASDAQ really got started, you know, really in 1986, and the market really didn't go anywhere and didn't break out until 1991. But between point A and point B was about a 900% increase in the NASDAQ. Now, the thing that to realize here is that if you found the leadership, and at that time, you know, breaking out in 91, it was the personal computer initially, which was things like Intel, Microsoft, but then it quickly evolved into internet, which was things like America Online, Yahoo, Cisco Systems, Amazon.com. Now, Amazon didn't come on until about 1997, and we're going to talk about Amazon this morning. But it just seems coincidental to me that the second half of decades is where this seems to set itself up. Now, one other final point I want to make on this graph is that you have to realize here the NASDAQ peaked in 2000. We are just now in 2016 breaking out to new highs. So you've had a long period here where the NASDAQ has basically gone nowhere. So what does that mean? It means to me that there's a lot of disgruntled investors out there sitting on other things other than NASDAQ stocks, and that's a lot of fuel. In other words, if this thing continues to uptrend, pretty soon all those people that are sitting on the sidelines are going to come in. So what has changed? Well, let's look at that. Here is a graph. Let me set this graph up. We are comparing a technology sector fund, a SPDR, the XLK, to the bond market. I'm comparing it to a bond fund. So if we go back and look at the change that's taking place here, you'll notice that when the line is going up, it means that the technology sector is doing better than bonds. When the line's going down, it means that bonds are doing better. But you can see here that this correlation has existed for quite some time. I mean, bonds have basically done better than technology stocks up until here recently, where we broke out of this pattern and have seen a major surge in outperformance of technology stocks instead of bonds. So what does that mean? Well, it means that there's something new going on. There's new something has changed here. This is probably the beginnings of a new bull market. So we've got to decide, or we've got to find out, is it cloud computing? Is it artificial intelligence? Is it e-commerce? We don't know, but there's one other change here that I think is worth noting. Now, this is a graph of a housing company, a home builder called Lennar, been around for a long time. Home building, as we know, we went into the big drop in 2009, which was the financial crisis, and basically this home building stock has been locked in a trading range for quite a long time, really about the same amount of time that the NASDAQ has been locked in a trading range. Well, all of a sudden, boom, we're getting a breakout in this housing stock, which is a change. This is something different. Maybe it means that the economy is going to do well in the housing area. Now, I want to take us to this final graph. I'm comparing Amazon.com, or Amazon, it's no longer Amazon.com, to a Chinese e-commerce company called Alibaba. Now, as many of you know, we've owned Alibaba since the beginning of the year, and we sold the stock here recently. Now, let me show you why. In 2015, when the line's going up, Amazon stock is doing better than Alibaba stock. So 2015 was a good year for Amazon, but then Alibaba started to outperform. So at the beginning of the year, we made the decision to go into Alibaba instead of Amazon. Well, as a result, when the line goes down, Alibaba stock is doing better than Amazon's. But all of a sudden in here, something has changed. All of a sudden, Amazon is starting to outperform Alibaba. So, you know, one of the mistakes that I have probably made this year is I kept trying to find investments that would compete with Amazon. Well, I've reached the conclusion that Amazon has a monopoly, that they're probably going to be the first $1 trillion company, and, you know, no guarantees, of course. And we do, I do have to disclose, we do own Amazon at this time. But we just feel that there's a rotation going on here, and it's just away from China into back into the U.S. where we have e-commerce. So I did include the top five this week because there's been so much rotation in the market for the last since Thanksgiving that I think it would be better just not to discuss any stocks at this point and just kind of sit on cash right now if you have cash. If you've got some big winners and they're in the tech area, you know, I wouldn't hesitate to take a few chips off the table, hold the cash, and just sit tight until we see where this new change is going to take us. So if you have any questions on this, please give me a call. Thank you very much.